Hence, but what is a joyful state? What is a blissful state which you feel? That is what the spirituality thinks. That's what we will be talking about. Real happiness does not come from external sources. How good a laptop you have, how many iPhone you have, how big a house you have got, how big a car you have got. It comes from inner side. And that is what the spirituality brings. In blissful state, one is healthy, successful, and have good relations with others. But most of the time, what we think that if I am healthy, if I am successful, if I've got good friends, I'll be blessed. No. If you are in a blissful state, then you get all these things. So what is Sikhism? Sikhism was introduced in Punjab state. It used to be, before partition of India, it used to be all that, but then now it is reduced only to this small area. But you will see Sikhs everywhere in the world. So Sikhism, Sikh means a student. And the prophet is called a guru. That means teacher. And the first guru, Nanak Dev, founded Sikhism in 1469. And his first sermon was, at that time there were only two big religions in India at that time, Hindus and Muslims. And he said, neither Hindu nor Muslims are great, it is your deeds which make you great. That was the first sermon. That's what we call about the spirituality, that it is your good deeds in the spirituality. And that is one he said human rights for all started at that time, that everybody is equal. So it is your deeds which make you great, not the religion, and brotherhood of mankind and fatherhood of God. Like in Christianity, we all call everybody your brothers, but here it's practical. My name finishes with Singh, that we are all brothers. And the lady's name finishes with Kaur. You can ask me questions in between if you want to. If something is not clear, you know, ask me questions in between. No? So believe in one God, and he's a God of grace. He does not punish. And six believe in karma. Karma means the deeds. It is our deeds which make us great. So we believe in karma.
Are you saying then that you, the idea of reason, so if you do poorly, you will reap negative results. If you do well, you will reap positive results here and now.
Here now.
Okay.
We believe in the present, not after death. We believe in the present, that if I'm doing good deeds now, I got coffee, I forgot, so I got coffee. I'm driving nicely, properly, no accident. If you say something to me, and if I say, oh, and you will come back to me, say, oh, I'm reaping that. But if I say, oh, hello, how are you? And I say, hi, how are you? Good relationship. So we believe in the present at this time. No drink, no smoke. I don't believe in that. No adultery also. So the holy book is called Guru Granth Sahib, like Bible. And it doesn't contain the teachings only from Sikh gurus, even from Hindu saints, from Muslim saints. There are five symbols to recognize a Sikh. That they have got uncut hair. We are born with hair. Every human being is born with hair. It is not only for the Sikhs. So to keep yourself as you are in this world, you have got no right to play with the nature. And to keep the hair clean is a small comb, which we always carry with us. And kach is a special type of an underwear for your chastity. Good character. And kada is a bracelet, which I'm wearing, that denotes the universe has no beginning and no end. And we still believe the science is telling us the universe is still, we don't know how big it is. Kirpan is a small sword, which represents that we should be helping the oppressed people. That does not mean that if something is happening, I should take out the kirpan and start hitting the person who is an oppressor. There are so many different ways, but it only reminds us about this thing. So this is a kara, this is a kirpan, and this is a comb.
What is the significance
yeah.
of the hair, did you say?
Hair, we are born with hair. Everybody is born with the hair. It's not only for sex, it's for the human beings. Every human being is born with the hair and they got no right to cut it. Nature.
So
if nature didn't want us to have the hair, like, I don't know if you know appendix.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't need appendix. And nature removed it slowly. We didn't need hair on our face or rest of the body, so nature removed it slowly as we developed, you know, from animals. But this hair was needed for some reason or the other, so they are there, like, yes.
Yeah, maybe just to add to that, I think it's just to promote, this is how I've understood it, to promote natural beauty, that you are pure and like you're with your natural self.
So if you cut it, you're saying to God, you've made me crappy somehow, or you've you're insulting the one that made you.
Yeah, man has got beard and mustache, woman doesn't have. You know, nature did it from the beginning to represent the Pooja man and Pooja woman. Even in the animal kingdom, it is same, like the lion and lioness. You know.
So you're honoring the value of how you were created.
Of the
okay.
moment, yeah. So the Sigurus always preached that outward appearance is of no use until unless we have, it's accompanied by true, sincere devotion and the ethics. That is the spirituality part. Gender equality. I read this book by Bernard, very nice thing he wrote. That the majority of world religions have placed women in a secondary position to men, which has been a major cause of conflict, frustration, stress, and mental disorders among women. If you see, from the time immemorial, woman has been a second-class citizen. 1693, women were witch-hunted and killed when the just came out. In India, women had no right to get out of the house. Muslims, they're always in the burqa, even today. In the Western world also, women had no right to vote also, up to a few years ago. So women, 500 years ago, 130 years ago, women were given equal rights in the Sikh religion. Marriage and morality. Most of our today's mental health problems are because of infidelity, broken marriages, children are getting affected because of it. In Sikhism, we put a great emphasis on the moral character of both men and women. Infidelity is one of the biggest no-nos in Sikhism.
Does that actually help to keep it reduced, or does it go underground?
With Western influence, things are changing. a lot. That's all. People are no more religious, no more spiritual. It is more of Americanism. So that is affecting. Sikhism does not believe that mental illness or any other illness is caused by spirit possession or violation of some religious principles. It is even being done today. We see evangelists curing the illnesses on the TV by putting hands, praying, exorcism. People from my country go all over back to India, spend thousands of dollars to take baths in the holy rivers to ward off these evil spirits. You know, spends hundreds of dollars here in Vancouver also, and these so-called holy men come all the way from India to help them.
Are you saying not through supernatural?
We do not, Sikhism do not believe in it.
Okay. So the hands-on healing, all that?
No.
That's okay.
No. Illness is an illness. Third Guru even made a hospital at that time. Fifth Guru looked after the lepers. He made a hospital for that. Eighth Guru treated smallpox patients. And this is the Red Cross. This is the tenth Guru. I'll give you smallpox. What is this? Bhai Kanaiya. Bhai means brother. You know, we call ourselves brother. Yeah.
Earlier you said that you believe that what you do comes back to you. Is it seen that if you do certain things, it comes back to you in health issues?
No. Miss, what I reap, what I sow, I reap. If I sow mango, I don't expect to get bananas out of it. You know, whatever I sow, I reap. If I'm doing good deeds, I'll get the benefit as good deeds. But illnesses, it's a body, it's getting illnesses, as usual. I'll tell you what this Pai Kanija, Pai means brother, you know, which is what we call each other. Those days, the Muslim king was waging a war against Hindus to turn them to Islam. And then our 10th Guru, though he was not a Hindu, he took up the kirpan at that time to protect the Hindus and waged war against the Muslim king at that time. So when the war was being waged and the people were getting killed, Kanhaiya was giving water to everybody. So the Sikhs complained to the Guru that in the war we are killing the enemy and here he is giving them water and reviving them. So he was called to explain, and Kanhaiya said, according to your teachings, Guru, every human being is same. Having different beliefs is a different issue, but human being is same. So I am giving water to all of them because they are human beings. Guru said, very right. I was just